Bloomdale coming out.
Her last two works have been extremely well. We're good. I mean, she's done it within herself, easy. Mm-hmm. And she covers so much ground in the mornings, man. And her strides, I mean, it's unbelievable. It felt like she's galloping out there. And I think she ended up going a minute flat this morning or something, right over a minute. So I think all things are go for. I'm going to probably start galloping her every day, starting Monday or Tuesday, like we did in Pimlico. Every day she got better and better and better leading up to the race. And I feel like she's going to, whatever race she goes in, I still have that confidence in her. I mean, every jockey probably dream of riding that filly. Having said that, we have a great working communication. We're always on the same page with it's like a good teamwork. I mean, I'm a team player, whatever it may do. Like, I might gallop one at 9:30 today, who knows? But whatever it takes for the team to keep the good air going, the good communication going. It worked in Pimlico, so I believe that can work. We can do it again next weekend, hopefully. It was an intricate part of our success at Pimlico because I got to learn more and more about her and figure out all her moves and what she liked, what she didn't like. And we got really acquainted that week, me and her. And it's still a little more confidence in me going into Saturday. So when I made every move in the race, I was confident doing it because she knew where she was and, every pole. So.
The Preakness split at a mile and 3/16 split the difference between the Distaff and the Classic. Can you talk about... with her, the difference you think you would make one way or the other, the mile and eighth and mile and a quarter, what does that do tactically for her style?
I don't think tactically, she's going to clip off 12s every eighth and wherever she may be, whether it's in front, whether it's 2, 3, 4 back, 5 back, 10 back, wherever she is, she needs to clip off these 12s every part of the race, and then she'll continue finishing like she did in the Preakness, I think, I'm not going to force anything. Kenny puts no pressure on me to where she needs to be in the race. So you're right, I get a nice cruising speed. But I don't feel like it's a big difference tactically, whether it's the mile and a quarter or the mile and eighth. I don't think it's a big difference.
Of course, in the Classic, there's other horses, and I'm sure in the Distaff too, but like Global Campaign and I try to think of them that are going to be looking for the same sort of trip probably as
her. You say that, and we all think that sometimes. We handicap races, and then no one goes. Everyone's taken back. But I feel like the Classic will have, they're going to have some heat up there with Authentic winging it. I don't feel like Johnny's going to try to raid Authentic this time. But after Baffert's post-race comments, I think he preferred Authentic be 2-3 in front, just winging along, going as fast as he can. So they won't be walking in the Classic. And then you get to this Distaff where, they're not slow. Only girl's not slow. But even a Swiss Skydiver is not slow. If there's no pace, she's on it. And if there is pace, she rates. So she's very versatile, very, very versatile. So there's no real secret of where she's going to be after you handicap the race.